Ze zijn hier en ze zijn midden in een enorme tour. En ik ben zo blij dat ze hier zijn. Mike Lindup, Mark King, Level 42! Guys, good morning.
Hello, Gerard. Thanks for having us on.
Good morning, good morning.
It's great to have you here. It's an honor.
I know.
Well, you'll be my special guest for the next half hour. It's pretty complicated. It's Radio 10. We're going to have the Level 42 Top 3 at 8:30.
Yeah, that's a lot of numbers.
There's a lot of numbers there.
It is, man, yeah.
But I'm going to ask you everything about your three best songs, of course, chosen by our esteemed Radio 10 listeners.
Oh, great.
Let's start at number three. What do you think is the number three in the Level 42 top three?
Something About You.
No. Could have been Something About You.
Well, I was just going through some of our other hits.
Running in the Family?
No. You gotta think hotter than that.
Oh, there's a clue there. The Sun Goes Down.
It's Hot Water, thank God. It's Hot Water. It received just 8 votes more than Running in the Family. So it was a close call, Mike. Ooh. It was a close call. So let's play that one, and afterwards we're going to hear the whole story about Hot Water. Is that a deal?
Well, you can hear some of the story.
Yes.
Okay, let's do that. Level 42, top 3. Dit is de nummer 3. Jullie konden stemmen, dat is gebeurd dan ook. Hot Water, 9:05. De nummer 3 in de Level 42, top 3. Door jullie gestemd, dat was Hot Water, nummer 3 in 1984. 1984, number 3 hit in the Netherlands. It's still a great song.
Thank you very much indeed.
Fantastic song.
We always loved it. Mike will give you a little rundown as to sort of where that came from.
Yeah, it was. We've been jamming on that riff for ages and ages, and the name of the song came from a joke, which is.
Yes.
Are you going to tell? All right.
Yeah. Shall I tell the joke?
Yeah, tell the joke.
Well, there's this butler is serving his master, and he said, "Would you like a hot water bottle in your bed this evening, sir?" And he said, "Absolutely not."
Okay.
He said, "I'm just going to take my bath now." So the master has his bath, and then he goes and gets into his bed, and there's this hot water bottle there, and he burns his backside. And he said, "Jeeves, get in here." He said, "What is this doing in my bed?" And the butler said, "As I passed the bathroom earlier, I heard you say, 'What about a hot water bottle?'" That's a joke.
Sorry, the hot water bottle.
Yeah, his name was Wardle, wasn't
it? Yes, his name was Wardle. That's it. And he broke wind in the bath, so he farted in the bath.
Oh, that's sons and daughters in hot water.
Now, right. What about a hot water bottle? Waddle? You see, that's what about a hot water bottle? Waddle?
Okay, I have to.
You have to think about that.
Have to think about that one. Maybe tonight I'll have the water bottle.
Have a bath. Break wind in the bath. And see what it sounds like.
Okay, the song will never be the same again now.
No, I know, but you asked.
You just ruined the song.
Sometimes it's better not knowing these things.
Sorry, I want to ask you about the next one then.
That's not what the song is about. That's not what the lyric is about. But that's where the title came from.
That's where the title came from.
And then there's one figure in there that goes da 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 da, and it happens to scan with "What about a heart? Water bottle, water, water.
What about a heart? Water bottle, water. What about a heart?
Water bottle, water." Yeah, well, you asked, man. Okay,
this is going to be a great morning.
I'm sure. It started bad.
Well, let's take a big leap forward. What have you guys been up to lately? I mean, you guys tour a lot?
Yeah, we're touring every 2 years. We're doing festivals every year, every summer. We're doing trips, you know, to Japan and Indonesia and South America. It's fantastic. As we've got older, we're enjoying ourselves on stage so much more. We have a brass section on stage, so there's 7 of us on stage since 2012, since the last Sirens album, and the band is just on fire, I think. Mm. I have to say that because that's just how it feels, and we're having so much fun, and it seems the more fun we have, the more people like us, so...
Yeah, everything Mike said is absolutely right. You know, this has been... If you were to ask me, Gerard, and very often people do say, "What's been your favourite gig?"
Your favourite gig ever. That's a popular question.
Favourite gig ever. And I can honestly say, hand on my heart, it would have been 2 weeks ago at the Royal Albert Hall in London because it was sold out. It was the end of the UK tour. and it was absolutely amazing. If you were to ask me what my favorite gig in Holland has been, it will be a toss-up between the night before last at the Paradiso, which was just fantastic, or maybe the night before that in the 013 or 013 in Tilburg was also unbelievable. And the shows are sold out. The audiences are absolutely loving it, and we're loving it. That's the thing.
I think everybody still loves your music. I mean, Level 42 never went out of style, I think.
Well, there was a period, I think, in the 90s when sort of Britpop came through, and it was fair enough. That's why we sort of pulled the plug on it in 94 for a few years, because, you know, we had been around for nearly 15 years at that point. And that's a long time for anybody to be doing, the one thing. The band had developed very well, I think, you know, that when we started, you're going to play Love Games in a minute, that was the song that broke us through here in Holland. But by the time we got through, you were mentioning other albums we made, you know, There's Something About You, Running in the Family, all of these different kinds of songs, Leaving Me Now, It's Over, Heaven in My Hands. There's so many different kinds of style of songs, but they all sound peculiarly like Level 42, but they're all very different songs.
They still do. And there are a lot of shows in the Netherlands, 12.
Mm,
yeah. Well, there's a lot of shows in other. What is the special Dutch connection? I mean, Mark, you have one huge Dutch connection.
Yes,
marriage.
I do. She's not that huge, though. She's.
Sorry.
Yeah, no. You said that, Gerard, not me. It wasn't me, dear.
I mean, your first wife was Dutch, and now your second wife is Dutch as well.
Yes, that's right. It's and there's an old saying that even a donkey only trips on the same stone once.
Yeah, you're
so
right.
So I don't know why. My wife Ria is beautiful, and we had a fantastic day off yesterday in Amsterdam. We walked around the old city, with the gate and the oldest house in Amsterdam, 1508. We had a fantastic lunch at Soho House. It's great to see Amsterdam has Soho House now.
I know.
Yeah, it's good.
Amsterdam is beautiful.
Are you a member?
Of course. No, I know I'm not.
Get in there. It's a good place. Yeah.
But your brother Nathan, who also plays in the band, of course, is also married to a Dutch girl.
Yes, he is. Yeah, he is.
Is that running in a family? Yes, what's going on?
Oh, I see what you did there. It's no, it's all right. Yeah, Nathan's married to Yeti, and they have two lovely kids, Jack and Emily. And Sean Freeman, the sax player, is also living over here in Arnhem.
Yeah.
And he has a Dutch girlfriend.
What's going on?
It's good.
I do the interview in Dutch then?
Well, you can with Mike.
No, you can't.
Mike, who's nou echt met je?
People keep looking at me and saying, are you going to be next? No, I said, no.
No, 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 okay. Let's go on to the number two. You just spoiled it there, Mark. You said it.
Yeah, sorry about that.
You know what the number two is?
Is it Love Games?
It is Love Games. Yeah, very good, very good. The number two in the Level 42 top 3. De een naar meest gestemde plaat eigenlijk, Love Games. Well, I think this was the first big hit in the Netherlands for you guys, right?
You guys broke us, really. That's why we sort of have such a good affinity with Holland. Because you were the first country that put us on TV and actually got us charted with that thing. And because it happened in the UK after it had happened in Holland.
We hear that more often.
Yeah, and you know, Mike just reminded me that we recorded that at a studio called The Vineyard in southeast London. Which was quite sort of, it was quite a rough area back in 1981. And it just so happens I have an apartment there now. And it's, like about three streets away. And if you'd have said back in 1981, you know, you'll be living two streets away, Mark, in 38 years' time, I'd have said,
no way.
No way.
No way.
No way.
All right. So see what happens.
It's incredible. I mean, how life changes. I mean, that record was, it just exploded for us. And we just were completely unprepared for it. You know, we're like 21, 22, 23. And it's like, you're huge in Holland. Gosh, what does that mean? It means that you you get to come over and go to TV and radio studios at 7 o'clock in the morning. When you have no idea that you're going to be doing that, and so you're up late and you're unprepared.
Oh,
and so
it's
on.
Terrible. We saw the Tom Steenbergen, who was our Polydor sort of boss back then in the Netherlands, and Ellen Neefjes, I think it was her name. Yeah.
Neefjes, I think.
Neefjes, yeah. And she was looking after us, and she was this stunningly good-looking girl, and I'm sure she still is now. And she had to take us to this TV studio very early in the morning. And we as Mike said, we really weren't prepared. So we were still out till 6 a.m. partying in Amsterdam. And we staggered into the hotel foyer. You know, we were all 22 years old or whatever we were. And there she was waiting for us, saying, "What the hell are you guys doing? You know, we have to go now to the TV studio." And we looked awful. And all of us sat there, well, except for Mike, all of us sat there with sunglasses on.
Yeah.
Do you remember? And they were saying, "Could you take your glasses off?" And I'm going, no.
No, it's not a good idea. It's not a good idea. Okay, that's a good story. And the song itself, Love Games, was it something that was hanging in the air when you recorded the album?
Well, this was a lyric from Phil. And it's you know, the learning curve for us was really, really fast. And, you know, that Phil and Boone were the main lyricists in Level 42, and neither of them had written lyrics before. So we were sort of thrown in at the deep end and just thought, well, let's have a go and see what happens. And it turned out that they were both extremely good lyricists, quite different from each other, but both very, very good, you know? And just to stay on the topic of Love Games, yeah, it was just an amazing record for us that did all the work that we needed doing. And it sort of proved the point that, you know, look, if you want to reach a wider audience, you need to have hit records. And that was a sort of a good lesson we learned very early on.
And this is this still one of your favorite songs to play live?
Oh, for sure.
Absolutely. Mm. Yeah, it's a classic because it's with our roots, because we started as an instrumental band. You know, we had to write a song to get a record deal.
Yeah.
And so there's lots of you know, the song is great, but there's, you know, it's really about the music for me anyway. You know, that's why I love playing the song.
And the whole catalog, I mean, all the songs, a lot of hits are there, of course, but could you ever think of something that radio stations 30 years after still play all the songs of Level 42?
No, that's just nuts, you know. It's fantastic. I'm so grateful and so happy that you do this for us. Thank you. But I'd like to think that it's because it actually was a strong song. And, you know, a good song will always be a good song. It doesn't matter whether it's 20 years' time or 30 years' time.
You're right.
I've just had a horrible thought. In 20 years' time, I'll probably be dead.
Well, no.
Thanks for that, Gerard.
You
thanks.
Still look pretty healthy to me. So.
Well, I feel good now, but I don't know about 20 years' time.
Well, let's listen to the number one of the Level 42 top three. What do you think is the number one, the most popular one?
Mike, what do you reckon?
Well, it's either going to be something about your lessons in love, so I'm going to go for lessons.
Hey, you're right. The number one most voted song, Lessons in Love. So nummer 1 in de Level 42, top 3 door jou samengesteld. Je kon een week lang stemmen erop. Het was nummer 2 in de top 40, niet nummer 1. Dat is wel weer opvallend. Maar het heeft wel nummer 1 gestaan in Finland, in Duitsland, Spanje, Zwitserland en Zuid-Afrika. Well, it's been time flies when you're having fun, right?
It's so they say.
It's the last one already. One question I have, when can we expect the new Level 42 album?
Oh, it's...
sometime.
It's a popular question from our listeners as well.
Well, there's music in the pipeline. There always is. I mean, Mike writes all the time, and I write all the time. And the boys in the band write all the time. The thing is, there wasn't one ready. It just wasn't ready for this tour. And the thing is, you see, Gerard, because we've got such a big catalogue of songs to choose from, the question is, which ones do you leave out then to try and put a new song in that mm-hmm. might not be as good as that one that you know people would really like to hear? And on this tour, it's been very refreshing because we're actually playing songs from 1980 and 1981, play a couple of instrumentals. Heathrow's in the set, it's going down a storm. We play another song called Sandstorm that's in the set, that's going down a storm. Play a song called The Chant Has Begun, which is from 1984. And you can't put in all new material because you'd just be playing all night. So you try and get the set a way that it works well. And I think this has been one of the best set lists we've ever toured.
Yeah. Good Man in a Storm, you know that song. We've never played it live before and it's been requested a lot by the fans. And
finally, there was time for it.
And so we put it in and it's really great to play. And so what's happening is a lot of the people that come to the concert that know our old material are going, wow, they're playing this song. And then other people who don't know our old material are going, Oh, they got new stuff
Yeah, some guy rediscovered it. He said, "Yeah, I really love the new songs." And you're going, "Wow, they're new old songs, man." You know,
it was great talking to you guys.
Oh, thank you.
We could go on for hours, of course, but you have a show tonight.
We do in Zwolle.
In Zwolle. It's been sold out. And then you go to Alkmaar. It's been sold out. Yes. And then you go to Vlissingen, which is sold out. Eindhoven is sold out. Everything's totally sold out.
so you have to come back. Thank you, Gerard.
Come back soon. Thank you very much for being here, Mike and Mark.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy the tour.
Oh, we've loved it. Yes. Thanks, guys.
Level 42.